The other thing that we're going to talk about in this section is epimerization. So epimers are stereoisomers that differ only in the configuration of one stereocenter. And epimerization is the process of inversion of that stereocenter. So if we start again over on the right here, and look in the center to start at that more stable thermodynamic enolate, we had originally started with the 2-methyl group cis to form that enolate. Under thermodynamic conditions, two things can happen. The first possibility is protonation from the bottom side of the molecule. So as the lone pair on the oxygen comes down and grabs the proton, that proton is coming in from the bottom side, and that would give us the starting material. The other possibility is if that proton attached to some leaving group comes in from the top side. So lone pair again comes down, double bond goes to take that proton, and this side it comes in at the top. Under equilibrium conditions, the more stable product is going to be formed. And notice, with the 2-methyl group cis, there would be a steric interaction between those two groups, or steric repulsion. That is less stable than the situation where the methyl groups are trans. So the product on the right is more stable, and on the left is less stable. Now, one place where this is very applicable is for drugs that are epimerizable. So, if you haven't heard of thalidomide, it's something that's definitely worth looking up to this story. So this is a drug that was given to pregnant women as an antiemetic. So this helps would stop women from being as nauseous when they were pregnant. It also worked as a sedative. But what was later learned, very tragically to some babies in Europe, was that it was also a teratogen, meaning that babies were born with different mutations. Now notice that we have a stereocenter in the molecule. So the R is a teratogen and the sedative, whereas the S isomer is the antiemetic. So one might think, well, why not just give a pure compound of S and not give this teratogen? The problem is that stereocenter is located right next to a carbonyl. And so that same enol formation and then inversion of stereochemistry is possible. And in the body, with lots of protons around and catalytic acid as well, that epimerization would be fairly easy. So even if we gave somebody pure S, it could easily interconvert in vivo into the R. So it is not possible to give thalidomide, even the pure S, to pregnant women. Now thalidomide has found other uses for other diseases such as leprosy, but definitely not being given to pregnant women.